Liam, just for you know.
Okay, so I know we're running a little bit late today, so thank you guys for running with us and hearing our stories, and hopefully you guys have been encouraged by these. Football's not on, so that's good, so we can go a little late. We've got a couple more weeks. So, for those of you who don't know, I'm entering my third year at UW La Crosse, majoring in athletic training and pre-physical therapy. So the easiest way to describe what an athletic trainer does, for those of you who don't know, is if you're watching a football game or a sporting event, someone goes down the field, ATs are the people who run out there and save your life. You know, but we're the ones out there who run out there and like, evaluate the injury, they'll rehab them, get them back. Kind of like a physical therapist for sports is an easy way to understand it, I think. So this summer I had the chance to intern with Athletes in Action. So a quick show of hands, how many of you guys are familiar with Athletes in Action or heard of it before? Okay. So even up until the day I left, I still wasn't 100% sure like what they did or, yeah, I knew a little bit what they did, but I didn't know totally all that they were busy with. So on the screen, that's their logo and their motto, I guess, or their mission statement. It's striving to see Christ followers in every team, every sport, every nation, by using the platform of sports so that everyone knows someone who truly follows Jesus. So I had previously thought that they were just involved in campus ministry, and that's a big part of what they do. So they have staff on, I think it's over 200 campuses in the United States. It's like what ministering specifically to the athletes. Their thinking is that athletes are people who are influencers. I mean, I know what I do, especially as a young kid, really looking up to professional athletes, college athletes. So their goal is to influence the influencers for Christ. They feel they can reach a lot of people that way. So that's a big part of what they do. They also send teams overseas. So I get this. So this is a team that just got back from Columbia, a basketball team. So they'll assemble Division I, Division II college athletes from all over the United States. And then we'll send them over to foreign countries. Well, this one was Colombia, but they recently sent, I think, a volleyball team to China. And if you guys know anything about China, you can't get in there with the message of Christ very easily. But if you're bringing a sports team, they like line everything up for you, so they'll give you a place to stay. They'll tell you who you're going to play and when. And the ministry that goes on is after they play the teams. I think they usually win. But after they play the teams, they'll then share the gospel with them. So we'll sit them down, someone will share their testimony, and someone will tell them about the good news of Jesus Christ. And they're usually very receptive to that because they have a lot of respect for American athletes. So like, I think sports is a powerful way to get into countries like China where you normally couldn't get into just as a missionary or something like that. So I was on this thing this summer called X Project as an athletic training intern, so that's a small picture. But that's the team we had. So there was interns from all over the United States. Some of them were Division I athletes, others had never touched a football or basketball or anything like that in their life. They weren't into sports at all. But they saw the value of the ministry and what could be done with it. So like, I was an athletic training intern. There were others who were in media, planning camps and special events, things like that. Along the way, we also got we heard like weekly messages, we had weekly Bible studies, weekly discipleship. So we were really being poured into ourselves, which is awesome. At the same time, we were able to serve others. So one of the main things that the athletic trainers did, that was the five of us. It was five students and one, so there's six that I can't count. That was homeschool. So there's six people there, five students, one certified. So our main role in the summer, we had two main roles, was to work with the Zena Scouts. So these guys are a summer league baseball team. It's Division I, Division II athletes. That come to Xenia, Ohio. I forgot to mention, that's where I was. Xenia, Ohio. It's like a suburb of Dayton, so in southern Ohio, little town like 25,000 maybe. That's where the world headquarters is of this ministry. They have a huge sports complex there, baseball fields, soccer fields, football fields. It's pretty quality and nice as an altar baseball field. But these guys are all believers from various colleges, and they come from the summer league team. They play other teams in the Great Lakes League, and it's similar to what we do overseas, but these guys do it in the States. So like they'll play a team, like they play a bunch of times throughout the summer. I think they play like 60 games in like 65 days or something crazy. So the last time they play a team, they'll also sit them down, share their testimony with them, with someone, share the gospel again, they get really good response from that. So our role was to be the medical staff for these guys, so take care of them throughout the summer so that they could perform their best and then do ministry after the game. So that was really cool to see these guys. They all went forward. I'm coming from a secular university, I don't see that a lot with the athletes I work with. So it was just really refreshing and really encouraging to me. And I hope that, I think they said this to us, that we really encouraged them as well. So that was a really cool part of the summer. Another thing that we did was we worked various camps that came through. So they have this nice sports complex, so every week they have a new camp come in. One was a Tony Dungy camp, so those of you who don't know, legendary coach for the Indianapolis Colts, strong believer. So he came, and we had about 1,400 high school football players come, and they had a football camp. So they got to hear the gospel from Tony Dungy, and that's who drew them in, was, you know, this guy's here. They want to hear from him. So these kids who, you know, inner cities, may not have heard the gospel before, got to come and hear it from Tony Dungy, participate in a football camp. So again, we just got to be the medical staff for that, come alongside them, and help them with that ministry. This picture is from another camp that we did called Ultimate Training Camp. This one was an inner city one. So inner city kids from like Dayton, Detroit, Louisville is how you say it apparently, all came to this camp, and it was a sports camp. So like, there's coaches from different Division I colleges, Michigan State, the Giants player was there, one of their cornerbacks, to help coach this thing. So these kids, what draws the kids, and these really good coaches, they're going to get better at the sport, that's what they do, but they also get the gospel shared with them, and they also learn how they can incorporate Christ into their sport, how they can, as Colossians 3:23 says, do everything for the glory of God, and that includes your sport. Probably the highlight of the summer for me was at the end of this camp, they do this thing called the special. So the special stands for, let's see if I can get it right, spiritual principles plus exhaustion equals confidence in the Almighty Lord or something like that. So it's a 20-hour sports marathon. Goes from like 3 p.m. one day to like noon the next day, with like 4 hours of sleep in there. And they're just going from one thing to another. It's volleyball, it's tug of war, it's crab soccer, ultimate frisbee, CrossFit challenge, everything you can imagine. It sounds insane, but the goal of it, or the thinking behind it, is to kind of simulate what Jesus went through at the cross, where he was tortured, he was crucified, just so these kids can maybe just get a glimpse of what he suffered for them. And then at the end, they have this thing called Golgotha, so they go, there's a local park, it's like a half-mile hill, they have to carry a 2x4, it's kind of a marathon, but it's supposed to be like a contemplative time for them, carry 2x4 down the hill, and then back up on their shoulders, like Jesus carried the cross. It's just really powerful to see how God worked in those kids that week, and especially that last event is really cool. For us as ATs, this was incredibly stressful, especially this first one. For whatever reason, they scheduled it when the staff at Athletes in Action was gone. So it was five students, one certified, 150 kids. Most of them, they don't know their bodies, they're young, haven't been trained how to stay hydrated, so we're doing our best, but we sent multiple kids to the hospital, many went down with cramps, so we were just working. I mean, we got like no sleep, so working for 20 hours, it was insane, but it was just cool to see when someone did go down, how the whole camp would just come around them and pray for them, and really be united in Christ through that. A lesson I learned from this is probably one of the themes of the study was, I think if God wants you to do something, you feel he's calling you to do something, he'll give you the strength to do that. And for me, it was especially little things, like not like, oh, God's calling me to China, he'll give me the strength to do that, which is true, but it was really emphasized like little things, like, you know, you feel the Spirit nudging you to go, you know, talk to someone about the Lord, or ask them how they're doing, and encourage them, and that may be scary to me, and that maybe some of you guys too, but if he wants you to do that, he will work through you, and it won't be in your own strength, but it will be through his. And we saw that here, you know, staying up for 20 hours, working with these kids, being incredibly exhausted mentally, physically. But maybe this is what God wants us to do, and he really gave us the strength to do that. So that was a highlight for me. I'm almost done. That is the headquarters we were at. So along with all the ministry that we got to do, and being part of medical staff for these camps and for the baseball team, just great relationships with the rest of X Project. These people are going to be some of my lifelong friends. Still keep in contact with them almost daily, about a month later now. And we got to, it was a great environment to grow in spiritually, great community. Everyone's just really encouraging. We did outreaches. We were at a gay pride event in Columbus doing outreach there. We did street witnessing. Like I said, we got poured into by the staff there. And we also were able to take that and then give it to others in the way we served. In the future with Athletes in Action, some of the team, they were called to become full-time staff. I personally didn't feel with them. So like I mentioned, they sent teams to China, they sent teams to Columbia. So in a couple of years, once I'm certified, I'm hoping I can still stay involved by being the athletic trainer for those tours to keep those guys healthy so they can keep on doing the ministry. So thanks for listening to us today. This is the last one. We're just going to close with a final song. But I hope you guys have been encouraged a little bit. And we just appreciate your patience if we're a little bit long. So thank you.